Today, I want to talk to you a little bit about go-to-market and the different kind of go-to-market strategies. And so what I'm going to draw down here in the horizontal axis, I'm going to talk about how much dollars, what is the price that we sell at. And on the vertical axis, I'm going to talk about what is the volume. On here, it is $0. And as I progress on all the way at this end, let's say in excess of $100,000. Zero people, and let's say all the way up here, in excess of 1 million people. If I sell $0 to 1 million people, what's that model called? Freemium model. So the freemium model exists all the way over there. Now, if I sell very few solutions at hundreds of thousands of dollars, let's say 10 solutions, 20 solutions a year at the premium price down here, this really is the enterprise market, Fortune 500 selling and so on. Now, what we see is that we have different go-to-market strategies for different part of this deal. It is pretty clear that if I'm selling a $100,000, $250,000, $500,000 solution, that most likely I will have to get on an airplane, visit that customer a couple of times to build a relationship and to truly understand their problem. But it's also clear is that I'm selling, you know, to 1 million $0 freemium users, I probably won't get on that plane and trying to sell them something. Two different go-to-market strategies. Now, from the freemium model, I'm going to draw up a little bit bigger. Like, what if the solution that we're selling is like $100 a year? What can I do then? Well, for $100 a year, you probably have to use some web sales. Like enter your credit card, do it on the web. If I'm going higher up and I'm saying, okay, what is about $1,000? What can I do for that $1,000? Well, maybe I can have some web chat online in order to do that and help the customer through that. And what if I go to, in this case, let's say $10,000, 10K? Okay, well, maybe I have an inside sales organization. And if I go a little bit further, well, maybe I have a hybrid, some part inbound, some part outbound. I get like a couple of different kind of sales organization, but in this case, probably forms of field sales, channel sales, and so on. And down here, I'm a dedicated account manager sales model. Different, very different go-to-market strategies. On this end, from a marketing perspective, it's most likely I must be very inbound driven. And inbound means like people come to me, I use market, I use SEO in order to do so. In this middle segment, from a marketing perspective, I probably need to start thinking about having some outbound activity, including outbound marketing and outbound selling. And as I get on this upper end, on this side, I probably are targeting forms of ABM, account-based marketing, in order to target them. And that starts to tell me that if I have three different kind of businesses, three different kinds, I'm selling to SMB, I'm selling to mid-market, I'm selling to enterprise, or I'm selling to schools, I'm selling to districts, and I'm selling to regions, something like that. Whenever you start categorizing in these three, you probably have three different go-to-market strategies. This may be your enterprise strategy down here, where you use a field sales force. This may be an organization where you're using like a SalesPod, SDRs and AEs, sales development reps and account executives combined in order to generate sales teams. And on the bottom end, I probably would have a different strategy, an inbound marketing strategy with an online sale, a chat portal, and so on. These three different plans online, these three different plans are really creating three different go-to-market strategy. Now, here's the problem. Some companies say, but I'm really good in enterprise and I want to move down market. Well, in order to move from up market to down market, you're entering a different go-to-market strategy. And you need to relearn how to do that. Some people are doing online selling and say like, hey, I've started to win the first few big accounts. How am I going to win a big enterprise? Let's promote the top salesperson on the team. Let's promote that person to the senior account executive selling to enterprise. Doesn't work. It's a different go-to-market strategy. It may require different marketing. It may require different sales options. It for sure may require a different product. These higher end market, what you generally see is a really big discrepancy. On this side, all the way up, people buy a service and expect a product for free. Whereas on this side, people buy a product and expect a service for free. Two very different worlds that you have to be set onto with your product and your services that you offer. This starts to indicate to you that go-to-market strategies differ per market. And so when you move around from one market to another market, you cannot just copy and paste your own pitch to the next market and hope that it will work, because in most cases that doesn't work. Hope that it helps you determine what is the right go-to-market strategy for our company and our product and the market that we're targeting right now.